Log Talk Radio.
I just wanna know. Are you ready? Yeah. Let's get intimate. Are you ready? Let's get intimate with everyone's favorite intimate relationship coach, Nakima Lee. You ready? Let's get intimate.
Me. Welcome to a well-deserved late-night edition of Upscale Desires. We are here to please, tease, enlighten, to give you the best of intimate information and erotic education. I am your host, Nakima Lee, intimate relationship coach and author of the book 30 Days to Freedom, Becoming Authentic. Tonight we're talking about intimacy and understanding how you can have a better relationship. I'm telling you now, it's time to tune in, turn up, and let's turn out. We're going to do something real special tonight. We're getting ready for Jamaica 2014. We're going down to Hedonism to have us a good time. We will be broadcasting live from the Hedonism pool. If you want to join us, make sure you go to upscaledesires.com. Hit our travel button and join the travel club. We are going to lots of locations in 2015 to include Riviera Maya and Mexico, as well as France. If you want to party with us in France, make sure you check out upscaledesires.com. We're doing something nice tonight. We're going to do a little bit of a feature, getting you ready for the Jamaica trip. Make sure you check us out again. Go to upscaledesires.com. Now, coming up right now, we've got a little bit of a erotic poetry treat for you, something to just wet your whistle. You're listening to Upscale Desires Radio.
Slowly I rise from my turn in his chair, my turn to be draped by his cape. His chair, having been shared by others, was no match for me, but I had heard his chair was the best around and well worth the wait. I had had mine done before, but the promise of exclusivity was an allure. He would be my personal attendant, attending to my needs and desires, his tool of the trade aimed at the ready, sharpened like a double-edged razor. He trimmed my edges and provided my two-week shape-up. His expertise on my eyebrows gave him access to my lowbrow. He cut me low like an uptown and high like an afro. Before I knew it, my wet follicles were on his face and pools just waiting for a wet nap. His licks hit me with angels unseen by no other. This nigga just don't cut hair. He opened my thighs, my ankles spread wide. He surprised me, and to my surprise, his dive was precise, like a kamikaze pilot. Nice. Tasted so good, he was willing to die twice, willing to sacrifice his life for a dream. Sacrifice for my cream, my Cool Whip topping present on his face, his hands wrapped around my waist. Like Wu-Tang, he desired my cream. He found the depths of my chamber, and till come, ruled everything around me. More and more, my insides would cry for his tongue and lips. Every lick and every kiss. But he was no match for my Scorpio sting. I had my hooks in him, but wait, he's a Scorpio, and I too was hit with his sting, and his venom coursed through my veins. With every lick, he would render me powerless. It was driving me insane. He would paralyze my thighs, and respiratory arrest would set in, and with each gasp I would try to breathe and understand that life for me, this nut was all I need. Each pass rendered me blind, so I chose not to see me, losing my control, and I was climaxing. Each lick sounded like a sword fight. The click and the clack of our rings made a vibration that surged my body till I could no longer contain it. So I cried out, wait a minute, motherfucker, this nigga just don't cut hair. Each time I just knew he would reach my center, he would reach my soul. I just knew that he was the one that was bold enough to hold me. This nigga just don't cut hair. He left me with tender strokes that made me seasick. This nigga just don't cut hair. He left me wanting more, unable to wait 2 weeks for my next appointment. I wanted my turn. Now I wanted my turn in his chair, for he owned my new style with his signature curve. This nigga just don't cut hair. He adorned me like a queen. He worshipped me, my life. He loved me. This nigga just don't cut hair. He cut me. He cut me. He cut me.
Listening to Barbara, erotic poetry by yours truly, Nakima Lee. Definitely check me out on stage this 14th of November to the 21st. We're going to be in Hedonism 2 in the Grill, Jamaica. Make sure you can come down. And if you cannot, everybody out in the ATL, if you're listening down there and you're a Georgia peach, we'll be hitting the stage in Atlanta with Sweet Spot Nation. They are an amazing, energetic, high pop erotica troupe. They're coming out there to Atlanta. If you haven't gotten your tickets, go to sweetspotnation.com. Get your tickets. It's going to be Saturday, November 22nd. It's going to be an erotic poetry experience. We're talking about burlesque, striptease, comedy, poetry, and yours truly teaching on the art of fellatio. You want to be there. You want to make sure that everyone is on time and plugged in. You are listening to Upscale Desires Radio with your girl, everyone's favorite intimate relationship coach, Nakima Lee, and You just heard the sounds of our erotic poetry feature for the night called Barber. Now, on to erotic news. Now, there is a rumor going around that Jaden Smith is the middle son of Will Smith, the older son of Jaden Smith, and the brother of Willow Smith. He is known to keep up with the Kardashians. He's BFFs with Kylie Jenner and Kendall Jenner. He also attended the royal wedding of Your Royal Highness, Kim Kardashian West, and the amazing talent and genius of Kanye. I'm sure he's taken pictures with the cinnamon apple that she is, Miss Northwest. But Jaden Smith is in the news. I don't know if it's a rumor, and I don't know if it's true. But many, many multiple news sources are reporting that the young man has decided at the age of 18, he will indeed cut off his penis. What? You say yes. This is the tea with Nikema Lee and your erotic news. Jaden Smith is soon going to cut off his penis at the age of 18. He asked his parents to understand his decision and also to help him with the finances of it. He does not want to be called a straight guy or a gay guy. He's just saying that I am who I am and that my penis size does not define me. He wants to continue acting. He wants to make sure that his penis being cut off and removed from his body to no longer to be used for procreation and or masturbation will not hinder his acting career, because far most important thing that he is an actor first, and that is all. Your thoughts on Mr. Jaden Smith cutting off his penis at the age of 18? He hasn't even begun to use it, in my opinion. I say, sir, don't cut it off. Give it some time. Let it work the middle and a few times, and I guarantee you, after you get you a little taste of a sweet, young, supple tenderoni, you will not want to miss out on something so exciting as sex. Again, you need your penis, young man. It doesn't define you at all. It just helps you to create and give your family longevity. That's what it does. So you should be proud and honored to have such a penis. Now, maybe the reason he wants to cut it off because he knows it doesn't stack up against everybody else in the locker room. He's saying, look, it's already small. It's barely noticeable. You can barely see it. So what's the point of even having a thing? I ain't used it yet. Now, I just want to remind you that Jaden Smith is only 16 years old. And trust me, ladies and gentlemen, when you hear that he turns 18, I'm going to have my ear to the ground, too, because I want to know if he's really going to cut it off. We hope that the story is not true. This is your tea with Nikema Lee and your erotic news story of the week. Jaden Smith, keep your penis on, man. You're going to need it. All right. So we're into our topic for tonight. The topic for tonight is how to have a better relationship. We're going to be talking about how to have a better relationship. I think that's going to be our running topic, but tonight we're talking about intimacy. We did a wonderful webinar. Make sure you go to upscaledesires.com if you want to join this webinar. 1 hour talking about the critical principles that you need in order to have a better relationship. Things like communication. You've got to communicate. You've got to stop reacting and start responding. You respond when you hear, when you listen. You react when you're talking. So you have to do twice as much as listening as you do talking, because you have two ears and one mouth. So keep that rule of thumb. Learning how to communicate with your partner, being open and free. And the only time that you can be open and free with your partner is when you can trust your partner. And the only way that you can trust your partner is to know your partner. And the only way that you can know your partner is to know yourself. Second principle on how you can have a better relationship is self-pleasure. And I'm talking about the kind of self-pleasure that you need in order to know who you are, what you like, what you don't like, what touch feels good to you, what touch feels bad to you, what you like to be licked, what you don't like to be licked. Because you can't communicate your pleasures and desires to your partner if you don't know what your pleasures and desires are. You've got to be willing to explore your body. You've got to be willing to open up your soul. You've got to be willing to let love in. When you can let love in, you can let love out. Yes, say it with me. When you let love in, you can let love out. And let it out all over him. Yes, it is your girl, Nikema Lee. You are listening to Upscale Desires Radio. It is a pleasure. Look, we've got so much to talk about when it comes to intimacy. Make sure you go to upscaledesires.com. Get on that webinar. We've got a couple of them coming up this week. You want to be a part of it. You want to know the principles. I'm telling you, there's so much that's going on there. There's little things like self-awareness, knowing your truth, being authentic, knowing that you are the best you you can be and you are living your life to the fullest. Knowing that, being aware, because it matters. What you think about yourself matters to what others think about you. If you can't get naked in front of your partner mentally, spiritually, emotionally, and physically, then you can never get naked in front of the person who really, truly matters. And listen, when I tell you that I am so pumped up and excited about letting intimacy end. Remember, this is the rule of thumb we use here at UpscaleDesires.com. In to me, see. See me. When I allow you to see me, the real me, the authentic me, that's intimacy. Getting butt naked with you and laying in a bed and rubbing up against your skin so that you can rub up against mine and we create a friction, that's sex. Sex is good. Sex is meant to be more. We have dumbed down sex. We have taken out the essence of it. We've taken out the soul of sex, and we've tossed it to the side and say that is only sacred for those who are in holy matrimony. And then those who get in holy matrimony, they say those are for those who are single. We are married. We just have sex. Are you tired of just having sex? Do you want to make love to someone? Do you want to create a moment? Do you want to transcend the skies? Then get intimate. Get downright dirty. Get in touch with you, and then you can get in touch with your partner. Not in a sense of, I just want to love you slowly and caress you gently and seduce you with my seductive voice. Ooh. Let's get intimate. But no, for you to see me as the barren soul that I am, the weak, loving woman who just wants to be touched. I love to cook. I love to be at home with the children. I love to be out there making decisions, but I need a man. I want someone strong. I'm a man, and I just want a woman who I can lay my head on and I can cry to and let her, and I can let the secrets of my soul out to this person. That's intimacy. That's when you insert your penis into a vagina that's so nice and warm, and it grabs onto you, and it holds onto you, and it trusts that you are going to outlive the promises that you've made in order to get this sweet nookie. That's intimacy. That's about empowerment. That is what we here at Upscale Desires is looking for everyone to get, because at the end of the day, we all want love. We all want love. We all seek it. We all desire it. But we've given up. We've been hurt so many times. We just toss love aside and say, I don't want to hurt anymore. I don't want to go through it anymore. I don't want to. No. But then we cry at night and say, God, I just want to be loved. Why do I have to go through so much? Why is the drama always in my life? God, please help me. And then it shows up. And you know what blocks you from actually making those connections with the person? Fear. fear, and we talk about the seven love blocks that you use in to block love from your life. The Seven Love Blocks ebook. Go to sevenloveblocks.com. Get this ebook. You're going to want to need, desire, have, and share this ebook. Go to sevenloveblocks.com, seven, the number seven, loveblocks.com, and get your free ebook. It's free. It talks about the fears. I'm telling you right now, fear and love cannot exist in the same place, just like darkness and light cannot exist in the same place. When light shows up, darkness goes away. When love shows up, fear goes away. But you know the only reason that love can't come into your life is because you're holding on to fear for dear life. You're holding on to those things that you think is going to protect your heart. But no, it's love. Love is the only thing that can protect your heart because it's the only thing that can heal your heart. You've got to be able to let love in. You've got to be able to let love shine. You've got to be able to let love move inside of you so that it can heal you. Because you know what the saying is, hurt people, but a healed person will heal a person. All right? Start living the best life ever. Quit being tied down by past mistakes. Trust yourself that you can actually pick a good guy. You can actually pick a girl that's good for you, that's the best for you. You got it in you. You know you can do it. I believe in you, but it's you who have to believe in you. You've got to know deep down in your itty-bitty soul that I can do this. I know I can find somebody who can love me. You know what? I don't have to look, search the Himalayas for somebody that's going to love me. I can actually love myself and project that love onto others and attract the love that is perfect for me. That in itself is a mouthful. You've got to understand that you are absolutely the source of all things in your life. So if life for you right now is chaotic and there's drama and there's so much chaos and turmoil, you've got to take a deep breath, silence your mind for 10 minutes a day, get connected and reconnected and in tune with the you inside and begin the healing process. Go to upscaledesires.com. Let the healing process work for you. Let it begin to work in you so that love can shine through you. It's time. It's time. It's this time of year. It's time to commit. What are you going to commit to? Are you going to commit to being single for the next 10, 12 years? Are you going to commit to this person that is in your life? Are you going to commit to being lonely? Are you going to commit to finding love within so that you can find love without? Make a plan. Make a plan. Make a plan. Make a plan today. Make a plan to find love. Make a plan to get reconnected. Make a plan to show the world that you can find love and that you have it built inside of you, ready to burst at the seams. You are the best you can be. Let's all cheer. That's intimacy. That's intimacy. That's living way beyond what love could ever be. This is your girl, everyone's favorite intimate relationship coach, Nikema Lee, and I'm telling you that intimacy in your lovemaking will change your life. Intimacy in your mind being connected with yourself will change your world. There's so much built inside of you. So much built inside of you. So much ready to come out. You need a coach. You need somebody who's going to help you pull it out. You need someone who's going to help you fill in the gaps. Every coach needs a coach. Everybody needs a coach. Everybody needs a mentor. I don't care who you are, what you do, how you do it, and how well you get it done. You need a coach. Let me coach you. Let me get you to the next level. Let me show you that you can get love, and I'm talking about sexual moments that will blow your mind. I'm talking about orgasms that last for 30 days at a time. I'm talking about living in the high of your sexual experience. I'm talking about making mental connections with your mate that you don't even have to speak a word. You don't have to even whisper to each other. But the connection is so strong where there's trust. there's trust and it runs deep and it's real and it's true and it's honest and you can believe in it. Do you want that? I want that for you. I want it for you. I want it for you. Yes. I'm so excited. I'm so super excited. I think that tonight, as we kick off, we get reintroduced to Upscale Desires Radio. We get reintroduced to Nikema Lee. We get reintroduced to understanding what it takes to have a better relationship. We're going to go into some really intimate things. We're going to talk about some stuff that people really don't talk about. We're going to talk about how you can raise children who understand sexuality without bombarding them with the images that go on, and understand that you two, as a mom, as a single parent, as a married couple, you can have the best sex life ever. We're going to be talking with swingers and lifestylists. We're going to be going on cruises. We're going to be talking about male enhancement, female sexual enhancement. Everything that you could possibly think about, we are going to be talking about it. We're going to enlighten you. We're going to give you much information. So make sure you follow us. Make sure you get reminders about this show, because every Tuesday night, 11 o'clock, we're going to get intimate. We're going to get deep. We're going to go low. We're going to go inside. We're going to get naughty. Are you ready to get naughty? If you want to get naughty with me, make sure you subscribe to this show. Make sure you follow us on YouTube. Make sure that you follow us and like us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. Upscale Desires. UpscaleDesires.com. Upscale Desires. Listen, it's been fun tonight. I want to give you one last point on how you can have a better relationship, better intimate relationship, better relationship all around. Let me tell you, understand what intimacy is. Understand that it's about redefining who you are and understanding who you are. And when you make that connection, when you let that light go off in your mind, and stop searching for somebody outside of who you are, outside of you, someone else to come in and love you, someone else to come in and make you feel happy, someone else to come in and complete you, then and only then will you find the joy of intimacy. And you can be who you are meant to be and live the life that you are meant to live. And each day becomes a better day built on top of better days. And when you build your life based on better days, based on better days, based on better days, your life is in its full richness. I have had a great time listening to you. We're going to have guests coming in and out of here. So this is what I leave you with, our Upscale Last Minute Moment. This is our Upscale Last Minute Moment, and this is what I want to leave you with. The joy of life is simply to enjoy life. It's your girl, Nikema Lee, everyone's favorite intimate relationship coach. We are signing off. We look forward to seeing each and every one of you right back here every Tuesday night. I look forward to your intimate Upscale Desires, how to have a better intimate relationship, how to be connected. Everything that you do, I do it better. Have a good night and peace. Be authentic.